Hello everyone, my name is Patience Noah and I am your insurance interpreter, and welcome to Insurance Talk, where we're providing consumers with knowledge to make informed decisions about their personal insurance needs. My goal for this show is to bring industry experts who will educate you about the industry, provide you with general insurance knowledge, and inform you of current trends within the industry so that you can be proactive with your insurance policies and maximize your coverages. I've worked in the industry for some time now, and in dealing with clients, one of the statements that I always hear is the fact that insurance is difficult to understand. And because of that, many people neglect their insurance policies, even though it's required by most states. Over the course of this show, we will discuss the different types of personal insurance out there, like your personal auto insurance, your home insurance, your personal umbrella insurance, and even dive into insurance like life insurance, health insurance, and investments. We will also touch on why premiums, some people know it as premium rates, price, why they go up every year, and the factors behind these increases. But before we get to these topics, I thought it was important we laid the foundation first and give you some basic understanding about the industry and get to answer questions like, how did insurance even come about? Who are the referees between yourself and insurance providers? And what are they doing to protect you to make sure you're being fairly priced on your insurance policies? After the break, we'll be joined by Mr. Gerard O'Sullivan. Gerard is the Director of Consumers Affairs at the Connecticut Insurance Department. Him and his team help recover over $4 million a year on behalf of policyholders from insurance providers. Now, keep in mind, I'm not here to help you discover which insurance company is better than the other. I am just here to simply help you utilize your insurance policies and make sure that you are being adequately insured. Stay put, and we'll be right back after this break. Hello everyone, my name is Patience Noah and I am your insurance interpreter, and welcome to Insurance Talk, where we're providing consumers with knowledge to make informed decisions about their personal insurance needs. Have you ever read your insurance policies and wonder what on earth you were reading? Or how about this one? Have you ever called your insurance agent or your insurance provider and hung up out of frustration because you simply couldn't understand insurance language? That's right. Insurance has its own language, and the truth is, not everybody understands it. Just like you, before I became an insurance professional, I struggled with reading my policies and understanding the coverages that were being provided to me. Join me as we dissect the insurance language and the industry as a whole to help you ask the right questions you need when purchasing your personal insurance products. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, and leave me a comment about topics you would like to see on the show. It's about time we break the barrier between policyholders and insurance providers.
Hi.
My name's J.C. McCauley.
I'm Naisha McCauley, and you're watching AccessTV.org.
Welcome back. My name is Patience Noah, and I am your insurance interpreter. And today I am joined by our guest interpreter, Mr. Gerard O'Sullivan. He is the director of the Connecticut Insurance Department. Let me let him introduce himself. Mr. Gerard, can you tell us a little bit about yourself and what you do?
Sure. I'm the Director of Consumer Affairs for the State of Connecticut Insurance Department. And my division mostly helps consumers with insurance complaints and answering questions about insurance.
Okay, and how did you find yourself in the industry?
Well, it was, you know, way back when, in the 80s, the economy was pretty down, so I was looking for anything,
right,
and wound up working for a national insurance company, and it was really just a stopgap until I found what I wanted to do. But insurance turned out to be so diverse,
right,
that I was able to work in many different parts of insurance and learn a lot of things. back about 12 years ago, I was very honored to be able to work as a regulator. Okay. And my job every day is to help people with their insurance problems.
Okay. And I think one of the things about insurance that most people that are not in the industry, they don't understand is once you get in the industry, it's very hard for you to leave. So it's those industry that once they pull you in, because there's so many aspects and so many fields that you can go in, it's hard for you to find yourself going somewhere else. So have you thought about leaving and going to another industry?
I have in the past. And, okay. You know, I was really interested in the financial side of it. Mm-hmm. But again, insurance companies do have a very strong financial side of it as well. So right. that option was open for me. And I did go into that a little bit in the compliance side of financial products. So anything that you want to do in the insurance industry, they offer it. So, you know, don't think that you're boxing yourself in because insurance touches everything.
Right, right. So, and with that being said, one of the things that I'm sure that the audience are probably wanting to know is how did insurance come about? And when would you say was the first time it was introduced in history to consumers?
Sure. And I'm by no means an insurance historian.
Yeah.
But, you know, it goes back to when it started in shipping.
Okay.
And, you know, companies would lose their ships with all of the things in them.
Okay.
And if they lost that ship and they lost all of their goods, they could go out of business. So shipping people got together and they helped each other out. And the loss of one person was paid back in by the whole group.
Oh, wow.
And that kind of spread over into fire protection.
Oh, wow.
You know, because if a person's house burned down, that's just a catastrophic loss.
Right.
So what it is, insurance, the whole idea behind it, and it still is today, is to protect people from catastrophic loss by spreading that risk among a large number of people.
Right. And the idea is to make you whole as you were before that loss.
Correct. Right. And whole is, you know, again, that's depending on the deductibles and all these other things.
Right.
A lot of people think, you know, it's going to be fine. It's like nothing is ever going to have happened. But insurance is a little bit more complicated than that. And, you know, in Connecticut and Hartford specifically, you know, it's been very important in the insurance industry since the early 1800s.
Okay.
And the Connecticut Insurance Department has been around for over 150 years, protecting people and helping consumers with their insurance problems.
Wow. And I'm sure as the industry grew over the years, obviously it needed to be regulated because, as we all know, you know, there are some fraudulent activities that that takes place within the industry. So there was actually insurance commissioners that were set up to make sure that they regulate, you know, these activities. So most people have no idea what an insurance commissioner is. So can you share with us what an insurance commissioner does and what purpose they serve in the community?
Sure, absolutely. And that's the thing that most people don't understand is that insurance is regulated on a state-by-state basis. So the insurance laws and the way insurance works in Connecticut is different than it is in Massachusetts or Rhode Island or California or wherever it may be.
Right.
And again, the insurance commissioner in Connecticut is appointed by the governor.
Okay.
And the governor gives the insurance commissioner the authority to regulate the insurance industry to make sure that the insurance industry is following Connecticut laws.
Okay.
But the most important job of the insurance commissioner is to protect the public.
Okay. So, for example, right, if an insurance carrier wants to come within the state, so can you walk us through how that happens? Because, you know, some consumers might tell themselves, oh, I live in Massachusetts. How come there's no Progressive in Massachusetts?
Right.
Oh, I live in North Dakota. How come there's no Safeco in North Dakota? So there are certain procedures that these companies have to follow that is being regulated by the insurance commissioner. So can you let them know how, you know, that works?
Sure, absolutely. And, you know, again, going back to the idea of consumer protection, the insurance department, through the state laws, state insurance laws, has requirements that the companies must meet. A lot of the national companies, they decide that they don't want to work under those rules. So it's up to the individual insurance departments to say this company meets the requirements of our insurance laws. Okay. And a lot of that has to do with financial protection, making sure that the insurance company is going to be around to pay the claims.
Right.
They're very good at collecting the premiums. We right. want to make sure that they're around to pay the claims.
Right. Okay. That's good to know, because like I said, I'm sure that's something that most people are not aware yes. of out there. And would you say that the commissioners, do they only regulate the companies or they regulate the industry as a whole?
Oh, they regulate everything.
Okay.
Again, and it's, if you ever have a chance to look at it, you can go on our website mm-hmm. and look at the statutes and the regulations. There are thousands of them.
Oh,
so,
wow.
you know, you have to be able, you have to follow all those laws, and those
right.
laws not only are on the insurance companies themselves, but it's mm-hmm. on agents who sell the policies.
Got
it's
it.
On claims professionals who settle the claims. So it is quite a bit for us to be concerned with and for us to regulate.
Okay. All right. That's good to know, because I, being an agent, I didn't know that. So okay. I'm sure a lot of agents that are out there, you know, is something that they can take from too. And I actually saw on the Connecticut website that one of the things that the commissioner office does is they help the community understand insurance and the industry as a whole. And I saw on the Connecticut website that you guys do have outreach initiatives. So can you share with some of our Connecticut audience what those initiatives are and how can they access those resources?
Sure, absolutely. And that's something that we're actually required by statute
okay.
to educate the public on insurance. Mm-hmm. So we have a speakers bureau, and we'll go out and talk to groups about insurance,
okay.
Educate them on things they should be concerned with, and most importantly, advising them of the offerings that we have in the Consumer Affairs Division of helping consumers with claim disputes or just information on insurance and how to purchase it and some things you should be aware of.
Okay, so let's say if I'm a leader of a minority group somewhere, I can contact your department to come out and sort of give us a little bit of, you know, information on insurance and how we can protect ourselves.
Absolutely. And you go right to our website and you click on the Speakers Bureau, and we'll, you know, set up a time that's convenient for you mm-hmm. for a person from our group to come out, and we can talk about insurance generally, or if you're interested in a specific aspect of it, we can also have a speaker who does that.
Okay, got it. And does your office deal with just personal insurance, or you guys deal with just insurance in general? You know, business insurance, right. like everything, you name it.
Right. We handle all types of insurance.
Okay.
You know, there are some things, you know, federal insurance, Medicaid, those type, Medicare, that we don't have jurisdiction over, but I would definitely recommend that if folks have questions, to give us a call,
okay.
and we can get them in the right hands if we can't answer the question.
Okay, great. That's good to know. And one of the things that you mentioned is that your department helps consumers settle claims disputes. And a lot of consumers out there have no idea, you know, if, for example, let's say a claim is denied them, some of them have no idea what to do. You know, they will try to fight it out with the insurance,
right.
You know, with the insurance carrier. But then if it doesn't work out, they get frustrated and give up. So at what point would you recommend that a consumer contacts the commissioner's office?
I think they should contact the commissioner as soon as they recognize they have a problem or a question.
Okay.
That's what we're there for, is to help consumers deal with insurance companies and to understand their rights and responsibilities.
Okay.
You know, there, in most of the instances where a claim is denied
mm-hmm.
on personal insurance for either property and casualty, your auto, your home, or specifically health insurance,
right.
the insurance companies are required to put our information on that denial letter.
Got
so that
okay.
people know to contact us. But even then, you know, not enough people reach out and actually contact us. They just assume the insurance company is correct.
Right.
And as you know, that's not always the case.
Right. And that's one of the reasons why I'm starting this show, because a lot of people out there, when it really comes to claims and things like this, especially insurance, people have no idea what to do.
Right.
And you have a lot of people that are either losing money or they're just frustrated because, and you have this stigma like, oh my gosh, like there's so much fraud within the insurance industry, but that's because they have nobody to go to.
Right.
And they don't know the right questions to ask
right.
either. So That was one of my motives behind starting this show. So basically, that was all the questions that I have for you. So based on your experience and what you've seen in the industry over the years, do you have any words of wisdom, anything you think that people might find useful in dealing with insurance and insurance carriers?
Absolutely. I think that the most important thing for people to understand is that insurance is complicated. We have specialists at the department, and they specialize in certain areas of insurance. Mm-hmm. When they themselves have problems, they go to other people within the department for answers because it's just a different thing, that type of insurance. Mm-hmm. So don't ever hesitate to pick up the phone, send us a complaint online, send us an inquiry online. Mm-hmm. And I always like to tell this one story that, you know, you're not putting us out. We're there to help consumers. Mm-hmm. And complaints actually help us to regulate the industry. We go out and we do exams. It's another part of the department that looks into the claims paying of the insurance companies. Mm-hmm. But the complaints from consumers let us know in real time what's going on in the industry, we can take action to correct that. We had one person come in, wasn't even sure if there was actually a problem, but you know, took the time to sit down, and we looked at it, and we said, we're going to have to do some investigations into this. Mm-hmm. And this one person turned out that there was an issue with, it was a health insurance company, mm-hmm. there was an issue with their claims paying software. Turns out they were doing it incorrectly. It wasn't anything the company was doing on purpose. Right. It was just a glitch in the software. Turns out that there was over $2 million in money that was to be paid back to folks.
Oh, wow.
And it was thousands of people in over four states. And this was something that was happening for more than a year. And nobody recognized it because they just assumed what the insurance company was doing was correct. Mm-hmm. And it took that one person who came to us. We got his issue fixed, and then we said to the company, how many other people has this happened to?
Wow.
So it helps us to correct the industry, and not enough people know that the Consumer Affairs Division recovers over $4 million a year for Connecticut consumers.
Wow.
And that's all based on complaints that we've received from the public.
Wow. So your department has a lot of work to do.
Yes, we do.
But in return, you really do help people and, you know, understand what it is they're dealing with. And that, I think a lot of people can appreciate that. And with this information being out there, I'm sure a lot of people will learn a lot from it. So thank you for joining us. Thank you for joining us at this time. I know you've had a busy day.
Thank you.
But you still made it out. So thank you. And I hope we can have you here again to talk to us.
Absolutely. I'd love to.
Okay. All right. Yes. Great. Well, you heard from him yourself. So we might have him here next time. So thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
We'll be right back after this break. Well, folks, that was it for today's section of Insurance Talk. I learned a lot, and I hope you learned a lot too. Well, like Mr. Gerald said, insurance is difficult, and us that work in the industry, we know that. We ourselves have to keep educating ourselves every year to make sure that all the new information that's coming up, we're up to date on it to help you understand insurance. So like he said, if ever there's a point that you need help, or if you have any state-specific questions, every state has an insurance department. They're either elected or they're voted into office. So you can visit their website and ask them any questions you want. If there's any claim situations that you're experiencing and you feel like you have no idea where to go, like he said, contact your insurance commissioner's office and they will be more than glad to help you out. Listen, we are on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, you name it. Like us, follow us, share the videos. You never know who might benefit from this information. Until then, see you next time.